paragraph 34, we dig to protect ourselves from the evil that surrounds us. We suffer only betrayal at the hands of the Warhaka. Once we are secure again in our mother soil, we shall strike forth with the fury of the storm. The evil shall not escape us, and none shall stand in our way. Paragraph 36. The raiders you seek are the descendants of the Earth people Malcolm brought with him to these worlds. You must capture one of these and bring him before the gates of truth. There you will probe his mind to find the entrance to Malcolm's domain. Once you have entered his domain, find the book by using the ability to seek out users of the light. Then bring the book back at once. Do not try to confront the betrayer now, for his power is too great. Go. Chapter 38. Can stares at you with a steadiness that even you find discomforting. They probably removed him entirely from the face of the planet. We were on a 3-day drive a week ago, camped out at night when he disappeared. Two of my men saw the kidnappers carry him off, and I swear that the bunch of them were farmers. Next morning we checked out the tracks, what was left of them, and sure enough, the prints weren't from any boots a rancher would wear. I heard a bunch of farmers, even old Gaper himself, were heading for Stryker Rift. It's common knowledge that the farmers have a secret starbase tucked away in the Shadow Rift. Where he is now, I don't know, but there'll be hell to pay. Paragraph 39. They woke us up one night, shrieking and howling. I never saw such a scene in all my life. My pa grabbed the weapon he kept by his bed and ran out into the darkness. I saw the bright flashes of his shots, but the green forms ignored him. To this day, I still don't know what they came for. They didn't touch a thing at the shop. I was frozen. I was so scared. I wanted to run, but I didn't know where I should run to. What scares me still to this day was the eerie way my brother stood at the window, as calm as can be. His hand was outstretched as if making some contact in some weird way. The expression on his face, I suppose that was the beginning of it all. Paragraph 40. The globe slowly rises, pulsating with the raw energy that completely illuminates your surroundings. I am the key of Thor. Tremble before me, vermin. I shall use you and your pitiful mechanical conveyances to fulfill my destiny. We shall go to Norjane 1875-1060, where the Sentinels reside, and crush them. You cannot resist my commands. Let us go. Paragraph 41. With a wicked smile, Riker presses the green button on the console of his raider craft. You hear the sound of metal grating against metal in the distance, and a muffled scream. She's all yours, boys, he says with an evil grin. Be sure to take along a spoon. Paragraph 42. The gates of truth stand open before you. Three old men dressed in scarlet robes sit just beyond the threshold. As you cross over, one of the old men smiles at you. That's when you notice that his mouth is filled with several rows of sharp, pointed teeth. Paragraph 43. This might be an actual paragraph, because I was never able to bribe Ruwal. Ruwal accepts the preferred bribe and grins. Sentinels? Yeah, I know of them. You feds don't want to mess with those guys. They look at you sideways and your brain explodes. I saw them stop a cave bear just by sneezing at one, once. Whatever you do, when you find them, shoot first and don't try talking to them until they're subdued. If you can kill one or two of them, then maybe they'll cooperate. If not, you guys are history. They can be found at Caldor 3015-827. The key thing to remember is that the next 43 is 75. Paragraph 45. Face to face with Lokanvar Avrensis, you begin to wonder if you are wise in seeking him out. He is a huge man without an ounce of fat to his body. His three bodyguards all carry neuron flails and look as if they eat Federation Marines for breakfast. So you boys are trying to stop the raids, eh? Avrensis says. Why, what gives you the right to interfere in a private quarrel? This one's between that wimp Gregor and me. Doesn't have anything to do with the Federation. We haven't attacked you, just his ships. Bet you don't know how he got the Caldor trade rights to begin with, do you? Well, it ain't because he's a public servant. tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to let you boys walk out of here in one piece this time, but if you cross me again, your mamas are going to be grieving for years. Now, you tell the Federation to keep its nose out of this one, and they won't get hurt. If they keep interfering, me and my Kishan allies are going to escalate this little fracas to a full-scale galactic war. I don't think your superiors would like that, if you get my drift. Now scram. Paragraph 46. There's only one way to get to our home base, the Raider says. And that takes a real pilot to pull it off. You've got to start off from on top of Kaldor Tower number 2 and hyperspace through the Gates of Truth. I can't tell you the exact coordinates for the gates. They have been programmed into my ship's computer in a language I don't understand. But I think a good computer hacker could get to the info. I can tell you the security code for that section of the program. Suddenly the Raider gasps and blood streams from his eyes and nose. With a gurgling sound, he crumples to the floor at your feet, dead. Paragraph 47. Why do I hate ranchers? The farmer spits on the ground. Those scum killed 2 of my boys in front of my eyes, and the only thing that saved me and the missus was the fact that we were hiding in the pantry. It was all I could do to stop her from getting away from me and attacking those thugs. Tears well up in the old man's eyes. All my boy did was complain about one of their steers trampling his cat. Them ranchers think they own the whole planet. They'll see. Pretty soon we'll take care of all of them, every last one. As the old man shrugs and turns to go, a crumpled piece of paper falls out of his back pocket. As soon as he's gone, you pick up the note and read it. It says, "Meet at the base at Shadow Rift at 0900. Ships are all fueled. This time we take them out." It is signed Riker. Paragraph 48. The apparent leader of the beast stares at you for a moment and motions for the others to leave. "Welcome, pale ones. We are the Kashal, and we have returned to claim our homeland. Many years ago, the ones you call Warhaka drove us from our lands. For 3 generations, we have patiently waited for them to cease their vigilance. Now we are striking back. They are treacherous, but we are strong. They must die. You must not interfere, for it is right that they die. It is not needed for you to die. Go and do not meddle in our affairs." Paragraph 50. "My name is Shilana," the girl says. "Pa told me it was okay to talk with you. He says a Fed is a good catch, but I don't want to catch anyone. I just want to be with Joshua Khan. Pa won't stand for it because he's a rancher. But I don't see why we have to hate all the ranchers. They're not all bad men, and I know they're not doing the raiding, because I know who it is. It's the Sentinels. You can find their base at Norjayan 979-522. Remember, the next 50 is 42. Paragraph 51. The screen of the computer terminal flickers brightly and then goes blank. After a couple of seconds, it comes to life again, this time filled with the image of an alien species you have never seen before. Below the image of the green-skinned creatures is the following text. "The Kishan race hails from an unknown part of the galaxy. They're extremely warlike and possess starship technology far beyond that of the Federation. Emissaries to the Kishan system have returned with their personalities completely erased. Each one has repeated the same message. Cease your expansion or face extermination. Federation behavioral scientists have been unable to reprogram the emissaries. What little information we have on the Kishan exists because of recording equipment on the emissary ships used by the first of our unfortunate employees. The other 7 emissaries returned in self-contained drone ships of unknown technology. As of yet, we have been unable to fathom the manner in which these ships function. Unable to access additional data without proper security clearance. Password." Paragraph 54. Just as you turn to walk away from the mysterious craft, a whooshing noise catches your attention. A small hole appears in the side of the craft, widening into a portal through which a good-sized human could easily walk. A metallic voice says, "Enter." The inside of the vessel is unlike anything you have ever seen. Bank upon bank of flashing lights greet your eyes in every direction. Sitting in the middle of the craft is a green creature you recognize as a Kishan. Its features are so alien you cannot even guess as to its disposition towards you and your crew. "Greetings, Marines," it says in the same flat, metallic voice, the time has come for contact. It seems Avrensis has told us a distortion of the fabric in order to have us pursue his goals. He will be treated accordingly for his deceit. It does not pay to deceive the Keisha. Our Mind Council wishes to hear of the Federation, for ignorance is not the basis for decisions. You will bring your leaders to Sejavik 1022-767 immediately. We shall await you there. The Keyshan extends an arm-like appendage towards one of the flashing panels, and suddenly you and your crew are outside the alien ship, which shimmers briefly and vanishes. Paragraph 55. As soon as you finish typing Clytemnestra into the Raider computer, the Raider begins laughing. Fools, he says. Now we're going just where you wanted to go. Home. When my master sees I've brought him a handful of feds, he'll be delighted. I'll bet I get promoted for this one. In case you guys have any illusions about fighting your way through, you ought to know that there are 10,000 combat veterans waiting for you where we're going. So settle back and enjoy the trip, dolts. Within a few seconds, the small Raider vessel begins to tremble and shake. Suddenly, you are slammed into the walls as the craft accelerates at an unbelievable rate. Don't worry, you hear the Raider say as you slip into unconsciousness. You'll wake up soon.